parts, spare parts of their body. If you have got any problem at all, come to me and I will fix you up with spare parts. I have everything here, arms, legs, heads, hair. If you need anything, just come to Honest Sid and I will get you fixed up with parts of the body. Hark, I hear a customer calling. Do I have any customers?
Chinkbox.
You must be the spare part salesman, right?
And what can I do for you, sir?
Anything at all?
I have it.
You can fix me up. Give me a new backside.
As it happens, I have got one in stock.
Here it is. I'd like to look at that. Spare part. Let's go. I'm ready. Here we go.
Now, sir, you are guaranteed to have piles of fun with this.
I'm ready.
Okay.
What a lovely fit.
Oh, that feels good. Yes, that feels good.
What a lovely fit. Are you happy with that, sir? Does that do that? Does you frown? Do you think it suits him? Do you think it suits him? That is smashing. That'll be lovely.
Hold it. Just a minute. I've been done.
You've been done? What's wrong now?
There's a hole in it.
There's a hole in it. Get out of there. What else have I got here? A young lady in distress. And what can I do for you now?
It's not fair.
Not fair? What can I do for you? You look ever so pretty. I bet. What is the trouble? Tell me. Honestly, I will fix you up with anything that you may need.
Nobody loves you.
And nobody will dance with you at the disco. Well, as it happens, I have the thing for young ladies in distress like this. They come to Honest Sid and I fix them up. I'm the number one ace guy, Spiff Mick. Okay, right, what I've got for you, man, just the thing you need to attract all the boys, so all the men chase you, a new bust. And as it happens, I have one in stock. Fresh in from Bristol today. Okay, now we'll just try it on the side. That isn't right. That's perfect, my dear. That's beautiful. Because now, what man would refuse to dance with a young lady like this? There we go. Another happy customer from Honest Sid, getting spare parts. Hark, I hear someone else calling me. Here.
Aha!
And what can I do for you, sir?
Oh, great. Have you got him?
Well, then, don't you dare touch that egg. Don't touch that! That was me, you fool! Now what do you want? What are you coming here for?
I didn't want anything before!
You didn't want anything, you want something now?
Something
here? Well, what for, Dan? What can I do for you?
Have you got a new pen?
that was all about the most famous street in the world. And right now, we'd like to pay tribute to that street and some of the greatest stars to appear on Broadway, none greater than Judy Garland, here with a tribute to Judy Shelley.
Come on, let's kiss it back. That's better. That really hurt. I need some paracetamol. I've just got an electric shock in my arm. Can you just kiss my arm better? You always look, can you kiss? Come on, it doesn't hurt. Are you shy? Okay, I'll get your husband to do it. That's better. Oh, that's better, because all these injuries that these rock and roll stars have are just going to... Who's going to kiss it better? Right. Ladies and gentlemen, this is Screaming Mel McKenzie. That's 1, 2, 3. Well, there's one more of mine. Greencoat. They won't have me, I can't play guitar. I don't know what to do. Ah. I work for the council. We were building roads. I'll see you later. Thank you.
You might be wondering what I'm doing up there with a cowboy hat on and feathers in it. And that little sign back there that says Sunny Things Nudist Camp. Well, I'm just going to tell you this, that I've come all the way from J.R.'s ranch up in Texas, where I was mining oil. I made so much money, I decided to get into real estate. And I got into real estate. Right here is a little property that was being sold, and I decided to buy it for myself. And I opened up for myself an exclusive nudist camp. Right? And it is exclusive. When I say exclusive, only the best can get in here. Now, I'll tell you this, that since I've been running this camp, you know, I've had so many lovely women coming through that gate. And I don't know why, they just can't seem to resist me. So for every 100 women that I've ever made love to, I wear a feather in my hat. I've lost 4 or 5, but I'm not wearing my hat. Well, well, look what we got here. Well, folks, I ain't seen nothing right. Where the hell's getting them feathers from, man? He got a lot more than I had. Would you be a prospective person to join our little club?
Well, yeah, I've come to join the Sunny Bones News Colony, and here I got my bag packed.
Well, I'm going to do the just hold on a minute, man. You can't walk in here with your bag packed, all ready to mosey on in and mix it with my little girls, because I've got to run some kind of... Would you mind keeping that still? I've got to keep some kind of check on my clientele, right? And so therefore, I have established a couple of little tests you got to go through before you get exclusive entry. And you know what I mean by entry. Right, all right, brother. Now, the thing that you got to do, right, we've got a couple of little tests. They're not too hard for you, right? The first one is this. Now, what I'm going to do, I'm going to get this here below with this microphone stretched that far. I got it. Now, what you got to do, because we're going to have clean people in this camp, I want you to hold on to this balloon, right? Now, I want you to hold it for a couple of minutes. Now, if you get a dirty thought or an unclean thought in your nasty little mind, that there balloon's going to go bang. And man, you're not coming into my club if it goes bang. You got that?
I got it, Buster. What am I going to do now?
Well, you just stay there for a couple of minutes and hold it. And the balloon. All right, now if you get one dirty and pure thought coming in your mind, that balloon will bust. Right? You got that? But it ain't that easy, right? You just hold there 1 minute.
I ain't going to get no...
Charlene, you out there now, baby. You know what you gotta do, don't you? We don't like this kind of bumming out camp, so you just gotta make that damn balloon pop. You got it? Go on and go get it now. Give him some of that stuff what you know home cook. Oh, I never got any of that. Keep on, girl. You know what you gotta do. It won't be long. It won't take long, and that balloon's gonna go bang, and we can sling him out that door, and then... I ain't seen nothing like this before, isn't it? It's always worth, I mean, who could resist a little girl like Charlene? What's the matter, Charlene? You can't give up that easy, Charlene. No. You ain't gone away that easy yet, man. Just because it ain't burst, you got another test yet, right? No impure thoughts, no dirty thoughts. Because if you do, that balloon's gonna bust. And you won't get in my club, all right?
Okay.
Well, you got one more test. You gotta meet our manager, Big John Thomas! Big John, you out there? Come and give this man a once over, will ya?
Hey, y'all! Why they call him Big John Thomas? You don't look so big!
I don't like it all!
Oh my God,
well,
now, ladies and gentlemen, we take you to our modern show section with an excerpt from Annie.
The sun come out tomorrow, bet your bottom dollar that tomorrow there'll So you gotta hang on till tomorrow. Come what may. Tomorrow, tomorrow, I love ya. Tomorrow, you're always a day away. The sun will come out tomorrow. Let your body
You won't believe me, all you prince, some old and some new prince. I'm very versatile, and if you're real good, I'll make you feel good. I want your spirit to climb.
Is another popular one from Elvis called Wooden Hearts.
Do I fit in?
Starting at 10:30, which is Escape to Victory for all the football fans. We'll see you a little bit later.